Hi, my dear children. Today we are starting with a proverb that is, good health is the sister of beauty. Good health is the sister of beauty. So become beauty, you should have good health. For getting good health, you should have balanced diet. So now we have to understand what you mean by balanced diet. We discussed all different kinds of nutrients here in the last class. That is carbohydrates, vitamins, proteins, that and all. And the diet which contains the right amount of this nutrients is called the balanced diet. So we can see the diet which contains the nutrients that our body needs in right quantities and a good amount of roughage and water. And then that type of diet is called a balanced diet. So what is balanced diet? The diet which contains essential components in right amount, that is called a balanced diet. So here we can't say this much amount of needed for one person, this much amount needed for other person. It depend upon the age and the physical work that we do. For example, the person who is doing more physical work, he needs more energy, so he has to take carbohydrate, because carbohydrate is the energy giving food. So different kinds of people needs different amount of nutrients. Anyway, we can say that the nutrients which is in right amount, that is called balanced diet. The diet which contains the nutrients in our body in right quantities and a good amount of roughage and water. The roughage and water, it is not under the nutrients, but it is an essential component. So diet should contain nutrients as well as roughage and water. That type of food is called a balanced diet. Okay. So what are the nutrients? Carbohydrates, proteins, fats, vitamins and minerals. And the nutrients and the water and dietary fibers. This together called the essential components. The food, our diet which contains this essential components are called a balanced diet. Hope you would understood. Okay. So we should have a balanced diet. Now we have to think about, if you are not having balanced diet, what happened? Is there any problem if you are not having a balanced diet? That we can see. Before that, you should understand, you should remember that water soluble vitamins will lose through urine and sweat. What are the water soluble vitamins? Last day we could discuss water soluble vitamins are vitamin B and B complex and C. Vitamin B complex and C, it will soluble in water. So when we are having this vitamins, after that it will lose through urine or sweat. So you have to take, or you have to replace that kind of vitamins every day. That means that kind of vitamin, that is vitamin B complex and C, should include in your diet, in your daily brush. Then only you can fulfill the requirement for vitamin B complex and C. And fat soluble vitamins are stored in the body for long time. What are the fat soluble vitamins? Vitamin A, D, E and K. This fat soluble vitamins, and so it can retain our body for long time. So need not to take every day this fat soluble vitamins. Okay. So if you are not having this balanced diet, what will happen? It will lead to deficiency diseases. Deficiency diseases. So now you have to understand what you mean by deficiency diseases. Deficiency disease is a disease which cause due to the lack of nutrients. It can be the lack of one nutrient, or it can be one or more nutrients. The deficiency diseases are the diseases caused due to the lack of nutrients over a long period of time. That also you have to note it down. So over a long period of time. Why it is long period of time? If you are not having a particular kind of nutrient or vitamins in our body for 1 or 2 days, nothing will happen. If you are suffocating with this lack of nutrients for a long period of time, it will lead to a deficiency diseases. Deficiency can cause deficiency of one nutrient or more nutrients. Deficiency of one or more nutrients can cause diseases. Then how we can overcome this deficiency diseases? The deficiency diseases can be prevented by taking a balanced diet. So if we are having a balanced diet, we will have a good health, or we can overcome this kind of deficiency diseases. Okay, so in this picture you can see these are all deficiency diseases. The first one is goiter. While talking about the minerals, the iodine is important for thyroid hormone. So the deficiency of iodine will leads to the swelling of thyroid gland, and it call it as goiter. Okay, so each kind of vitamins or minerals or nutrients have its own function. The deficiency of these kinds of nutrients will lead to some kind of diseases that we are going to discuss now. Okay, do you understand what you mean by deficiency diseases? It is the diseases that occur due to the lack of nutrients over a long period are called deficiency diseases. Good. Okay, then deficiency diseases can be prevented by taking balanced food. These 2 points you have to remember. Okay, so now we are going to discuss about what will happen if you are having deficiency in different nutrients. First one, the carbohydrate deficiency. What will happen if you are having carbohydrate deficiency? Carbohydrate nutrient is called energy giving nutrient. So energy giving food is called carbohydrate. If you are not having carbohydrate in enough amount, what will happen? We won't get energy. Okay, so it will lead to stunted growth. Okay, and this disease is called marasmus and kwashiorkor. Marasmus or kwashiorkor. Okay, so carbohydrate is energy giving nutrient. The deficiency lead to stunted growth, that called marasmus or kwashiorkor. Okay, good. Marasmus or kwashiorkor, it is because of the deficiency of carbohydrate. Then what will happen if we are not having protein in enough amount of protein? Protein is called a bodybuilding nutrient. Bodybuilding because it is needed for repairment and growth of the body. So it is called a bodybuilding nutrient. And if we are having the protein deficiency, we will show this kind of signs, that is constant craving. What do you mean by craving? Something is just if we will want in more amount, that is constant craving. This time you may think that the constant craving, sometimes you will have a constant craving for chocolates or ice creams or sweets. It is not because of protein deficiency. It is because of getting a favorite taste, that's all. But if you having protein deficiency, you will have a constant craving for food. And other sign is muscle and joint pain. You will feel muscle pain or joint pain if you having protein deficiency. Other sign is can't sleep well. And fourth sign is low energy, moodiness and stress. This all sign shows that you are suffering from protein deficiency. Got the idea? Protein deficiency, protein is called a bodybuilding food or bodybuilding nutrient, and deficiency leads to some kind of disease that we will discuss later. And if you have a protein deficiency, you will show this kind of signs. And this shows that you are having a protein deficiency. Okay. Then I told you protein is important for growth and maintenance of our body, and is very important for muscles, skin, hormones or enzymes, etc. And the deficiency leads to stunted growth and other face swelling. That means you will have a big face and a small body. Face swelling and discoloration of hair. You will lose the original color of the hair. And skin diseases. It will lead to so many kind of skin diseases. Also it will lead to diarrhea. Okay, these are the deficiency diseases due to protein deficiency. Okay, protein deficiency, protein is important for growth and maintenance, so it is called a bodybuilding food, and it is important for muscle, skin, hormones or enzymes, etc. And the deficiency lead to stunted growth, face swelling, discoloration of hair, skin diseases, diarrhea. What the idea? Okay. Then, vitamin deficiency we will study later. Now we are going to mineral deficiency. How many minerals are there? 16 different kinds of minerals are needed in our body, and each mineral have its own function. So here we can't discuss all 16 type of minerals and deficiency. So we'll discuss together. Now we take as an example of calcium. Calcium is important for teeth and bones, and it is important for muscle movement and the nervous system. So if the deficiency, if we are not having enough amount of calcium, what will happen? It will cause us muscular cramps, abnormal heartbeat or toothache, like that. Okay, so minerals deficiency leads to different kinds of diseases, that is fatigue, poor performance, anemia. And fatigue means you are feeling too much tiredness. Poor performance means curricular or co-curricular activities will show poor performance because of the mineral deficiency. And anemia means in your blood there is less amount of red blood cells or hemoglobin, and it will leads to anemia. This is called anemia. Okay, these are the some examples for mineral deficiency diseases. Okay, what the idea? Minerals are important for our body, and mineral deficiency leads to fatigue, poor performance, anemia, etc., etc. Different 16 different kinds of minerals are there, and each mineral deficiency leads to different kinds of diseases. We are not discussing all the different diseases here. We are discussing only some deficiency diseases. Okay. So now we are moving to vitamin deficiency. What do you mean by vitamin deficiency? Vitamin deficiency is the deficiency due to the vitamin. How many vitamins are there? There are 13 different kinds of vitamins. Each vitamin have different functions. So each vitamin deficiency lead to different kinds of diseases also. Okay. So here we are taking four different vitamins as an example. Okay, the first one is vitamin A. What is importance for vitamin A? Vitamin A is important for health of eye. Okay, so deficiency of vitamin A leads to poor vision or night blindness or complete blindness. Okay, vitamin A deficiency leads to poor vision, night blindness or complete blindness, because vitamin A is important for eye. And then vitamin B1 is important for muscles, and it is helping to convert the carbohydrate into energy. The body can convert the food into energy with the help of vitamin B1. Good. So vitamin B1 deficiency will lead to very little energy to work, because the absence of vitamin B1, the body can't convert the carbohydrate into energy. So it will lead to very little energy to work. Also, you will feel weak muscles. Vitamin B1 deficiency. And this disease is called the beriberi. Beriberi. B-E-R-I, beriberi. Okay, vitamin B1 deficiency. Vitamin B1 is important for converting glucose or carbohydrate into energy, and the deficiency leads to weak muscle or very little energy to work, and the disease is called beriberi. What the idea? Weak muscle, very little energy to work, and the disease is called beriberi. So vitamin B1 leads to the disease called beriberi. And vitamin A1 deficiency leads to poor vision or night blindness, etc. Good. Okay, then go to move into vitamin D. Vitamin D is important for teeth and this bones. Okay, so vitamin B1 D deficiency leads to poor absorption of calcium. So the body can absorb calcium with the help of vitamin D1. Body can absorb calcium with the help of vitamin D1. So vitamin D1 deficiency leads to poor absorption of calcium and bones become soft and weak. And this deficiency disease is called rickets. R-I-C-K-E-T-S. Rickets. What the idea? Okay, vitamin D1, it is important for absorption of calcium, and the deficiency leads to poor absorption of calcium, and the you will feel bones become soft and weak, and it will bend also, and the disease is called rickets. But then we are moving to vitamin C1. Vitamin C1 is important for good health and also for tissue healing. And if you are having vitamin C deficiency, what will happen? Bleeding from gums and inability for body to heal wounds. Vitamin C deficiency leads to bleeding from gums and the inability of body to heal wounds. That means if you are getting some wounds, it will take too much time for healing. And this particular deficiency disease is called scurvy. Scurvy, S-C-U-R-V-Y, scurvy. Got? So vitamin C deficiency leads to scurvy, and vitamin D deficiency leads to rickets. Got? So once more we can see, vitamin A deficiency, it is important for eye, and deficiency leads to poor vision or night blindness. And the vitamin B1 deficiency leads to beriberi, and vitamin D deficiency leads to rickets. Vitamin C deficiency leads to scurvy. Got the idea? So these names you have to remember: poor vision, beriberi, rickets, scurvy. Poor vision because of deficiency of vitamin A, and beriberi leads because of deficiency of vitamin B1, rickets due to the deficiency of vitamin D, and scurvy due to the deficiency of vitamin C. Okay, hope you got the idea. So here you can see a chart showing the deficiency diseases of vitamins and minerals. Vitamin A, we already discussed, loss of vision, poor vision, loss of vision, darkness, sometimes complete loss of vision. And vitamin B1, the deficiency disease is called beriberi. And what is the symptom? Weak muscles and very little energy to work. Vitamin C deficiency disease is called scurvy, and symptom is bleeding gums, wounds take longer time to heal. And vitamin D disease is called rickets. What is the symptom? Bones become soft and bent. Bones become soft and bent. And the disease is called rickets due to the lack of vitamin D. Okay, this chart is important for you. So try to study this chart. Okay, then calcium. The deficiency disease is bones and teeth decay. And symptom is big bones, tooth decay. Good. Idea, the deficiency disease is called mineral iodine, and deficiency disease is called goiter. Symptom, glands in the neck appear swollen, mental disability in children. We already discussed the goiter, that is the glands in the neck appear swollen, mental disability in children. And the mineral iron, the deficiency disease is called anemia. What do you mean by anemia? It is the less it is because of less amount of blood, red blood cells or hemoglobin in the blood, and the symptom is weakness. You are feeling some kind of weakness. So go through the chart once more. Vitamin A, loss of vision. Vitamin B1, beriberi. Vitamin C, scurvy. Vitamin D, rickets, calcium, bone and tooth decay, iodine, goiter, iron, anemia. Got the idea? Okay. So, how we can overcome this deficiency diseases? We already discussed that. That is, deficiency diseases can be overcome by having balanced diet. Deficiency diseases can be prevented by taking balanced diet. So in this chart you can see the amount of food what we have to take. That is the a chart for balanced diet. How much amount you have to have grains, how much amount you should take vegetables, like that and all. Okay. See here, the most of the part of this chart is containing grains. That means you should have more amount of grains in your food. Grains means like rice or wheat, the products. Okay, so you should have in this chapter we can say about 50% of this chart is about grains. So when you are balanced diet, about 50% should contain this grains like rice or wheat. That's why we are having main food item as rice or wheat. We are all having rice, we are more rice or wheat. Am I correct? So it is because of that. Why it is so? Because this contains more carbohydrates and it is the energy giving food. We need too much energy, so we should have more grains in our food. Okay. Then next is vegetables. About 20% is vegetables. Okay, so in your food, the 20% should be different kinds of vegetables. Okay, then about 10% of fruits and 10% of meat, fish, egg and other alternatives. So 50% grains, 20% vegetables, 10% fruits, and other 10% meat, fish, egg, or other. Okay, so how much it is total? 50, 20, 10, 10. That is 90. Then other 10%, 5% is for milk and milk products, and other 5% is for fat or oil, salt, and sugar. So you should have in less amount of fat, salt and sugar and more amount of grains. Okay. What? So you should have more amount of grains in your food and also vegetables and fruits and meat should contain and other milk and other products, fat, oil and sugar in less amount. Okay. This is about the balanced diet. Hope you could understand now. Here is one activity that you have to note it down, and after that you should complete the chart. Prepare a chart of your food over a period of a week and check whether all the nutrients mentioned are present in your diet. So you should prepare a chart daily for 1 week, and it should contain the food what you are eating for 1 week, for supper, for breakfast, lunch, supper and coffee, and you have to mention if you are taking other food like fruits or sweets, something like that, and you have to prepare the chart for 1 week, and you should submit afterwards. So the activity is prepare a chart of your food over a period of week and check whether all the nutrients mentioned are present. Okay, this I will send you in your class groups that you have to do. This much only about our chapter. Okay, so today what we discuss about balanced diet and deficiency diseases. What do you mean by balanced diet? The diet which contains nutrients in essential amounts and also the dietary fibers and water. That type of food is called a balanced diet. And deficiency of balanced diet will lead to some kind of balanced diseases. That is called deficiency diseases. And what are the deficiency diseases due to different kinds of nutrients? That also we could discuss. So in this chapter, together what and all we discuss, first we discussed about what you mean by nutrients. What are the nutrients? It is the essential components of food called nutrients. How many nutrients are there? 5 nutrients are there. Which are they? Carbohydrates, fats, proteins, vitamins and minerals. Also, the roughage and water also, roughage and water also essential components, it also should included in our food. So this essential components together in right quantities, that is called the balanced diet. Okay, this now then we discussed about what you mean by balanced diet, and we discussed about deficiency diseases. Okay, this much only this chapter. Hope you got understand.